Welcome, foolish mortals, and stay tuned for this month's Did You Know About the Haunted Mansion.
Hinges creak in doorless chambers, and strange and frightening sounds echo through the halls. Whenever candlelights flicker, where the air is deathly still, that is the time when ghosts are present, practicing their terror with ghoulish delight. Welcome, foolish mortals, to the Haunted Mansion. I am your host, your ghost host. Kindly step all the way in, please, and make room for everyone. There's no turning back now.
Hey there, this is Lady Jamers, and in my research for the Haunted Mansion, I found enough information to film a 2-hour Did You Know video. And really, as much as it might be fun to watch it, I thought that let's narrow it down to like 15-20 minutes or so. And so therefore, I'm going to tell you some about my favorite bits and pieces that I learned when I was doing this research. Now, a little bit about the history of the Haunted Mansion, the one in Disneyland, because that was the first one that was built. It took years to build the original Haunted Mansion in Disneyland. In 1957, Walt Disney approached Imagineer Ken Anderson about an idea of a walk-through Haunted Mansion with the maids and the butlers giving a guided tour of this manor house. And it was to be a sea captain and his bride. And they were also going to have a museum of the weird, but they decided against that one part. They built a southern plantation style house in New Orleans Square. And the facade was started in 1962. It finished in 1963, and then it kind of more or less became a real haunted house, if you know what I mean. Because at that time, Walt Disney decided that he wanted to pay all his attention to the New York World's Fair that was in 1964. So basically, the Haunted Mansion was put on a shelf for, you know what I mean. So they basically didn't touch it until after Walt Disney's death in 1966. Then they struggled with different ideas of what to do because they decided on doing dune buggies and not the walkthrough. And what you have today opened up on August 9th, 1969. one of the Imagineers who worked on the Haunted Mansion was named Yale Gracie. Does Gracie sound any familiar? Do you recognize the name? And for those of us who are Walt Disney World fans, know that they named the Haunted Mansion in Walt Disney World Gracie Manor Mansion. And basically, I think, I'm not 100% sure because I looked and I couldn't find that Disneyland and Disney World are both called, named after Yale Gracie. So, two of my favorite rooms in the Haunted Mansion are the stretching room and the ballroom. And that is, I'm going to tell you a little bit about. The stretching room in Disneyland is an elevator which takes you to the basement, and that is where you get on the ride and everything. In Disney World, they literally raise the roof. And the reason for this is that you don't go in the basement. The pictures flowed up, and when the pandemic happened, they decided to keep them stretched, and we rushed through my favorite room, and we didn't get to hear Paul Frees say, you have to find a way out. There is always my way. And then you hear a lady scream. Now, in the ballroom, there's three tidbits I have. The two duelers on the wall are said to be Alexander Hamilton and Aaron Burr. And if you look closely, you kind of, they're dressed in like 1805 gear, outfits and all. The organ in Disneyland is the same organ that was used in the movie 200,000 Leagues Under the Sea. And actor James Mason played that organ in the movie. Now, to get the same look, what they did is they made a replica out of the one that they used in the movie. And the dancing is another little tidbit I wanted to tell you about. Now, it looks like ghosts are dancing, right? Kind of pictured kind of on whatever. But there are actually animatronics of those dancers. The effect is called Pepper's Ghost. Basically, it's named after English scientist John Henry Pepper, who used this effect in a demonstration in 1862. It basically works with mirrors. So, what you do is that you get the image, be it an animatronic dancing, a bride, standing and talking, or whatever. And then you artfully reflect the item, and it bounces off like it's a ghost. And it is, as you've seen, it does make a really cool 3D effect beyond the glass. Now here's an interesting tidbit about the graveyard. Did you know that Tony the Tiger of Frosted Flakes fame is in the Haunted Mansion? Well, his voice is the voice of actor Thurl Ravenscroft, who does the voice of Tony the Tiger, does the main singing voice in the graveyard scene, and he sings the Grim Grinning Ghost Song. He's the main bust. And I thought that was kind of interesting if you think about it. And Madame Leota, her voice is voiced by the same person who did Madame Tremaine, Lady Tremaine rather, and Maleficent. And that is Eleanor Audley. Now, the actual face, the original face of Madame Leota is one of the Imagineers. So, as you've heard, the people who worked on the Haunted Mansion actually got things named after them in the Haunted Mansion. Now, Imagineer Leota Toombs was significant in doing things for the Pirates of the Caribbean and much, much more. And her daughter, Kim Irvine, is now an Imagineer in her own right. And she has said to have said hello to her mom when she goes on the Haunted Mansion ride. And she will also make an appearance on Muppets Haunted Mansion, which is coming up real soon. In fact, it probably will have come out a little bit before this does, because I put the Did You Knows in the third Thursday of every month. Now, like I said at the beginning, there's so much more we could talk about for the Haunted Mansion. We could talk about each and every Haunted Mansion there is. There is one in Tokyo, Hong Kong, Paris, and each of them is a little bit different. I will tell you that I have a fondness for the Disney World Haunted Mansion. I love the shape. It looks like a sea captain's house to me. And I love how it's glowed up in the, when it's nighttime. And during Halloween, I absolutely love to hear like Carlotta and the butler and have them do their little stories. I get a kick out of that. And I want to thank the vloggers for giving me the opportunity to see that. So, like I said, maybe another time I will go through and talk about more things about the Haunted Mansion. But for now, this is Lady Jamers saying like, subscribe, tell your friends about Lady Jamers' channel, and remember to hit those notification bells to be reminded of every video. And stay tuned for my little montage and some bonuses from my intro. And I made a little outro too. Take care, stay safe, have a happy Halloween, and we will see you later. Bye bye. Welcome to Oliver walking across the screen in the intro. Good evening. This is Lady Jamers, and in this month, did you know? We are going to the Haunted Mansion. In the Haunted Mansion, there are 999 souls that reside there. There's always room for one more.
While the crypt doors creak and the tombstones quake,
spooks come out for a swing and wake.
Happy haunts materialize
and begin to vocalize. Grim grinning ghosts come out to socialize.
Now don't close your eyes and don't try to hide,
for a silly spook they sit by your side,
shrouded in a darkish hide.
They pretend to terrorize. Come out to socialize.
As the moon climbs high o'er the dead oak tree,
spooks arrive for the midnight spree.
Creepy creeps with eerie eyes,
sharks to shriek and harmonize.
Grim green ghosts come out to socialize.
When you hear the knell of a requiem bell,
weird ghosts dream where spirits dwell.
Restless bones etherealize,
rise as spooks of every size.
When the crypt doors creak and the tombstones quake, spooks come out for a swinging wake. Happy hearts materialize and begin to vocalize. Grim grinning ghosts come out to socialize.
Now don't close your eyes and don't try to hide, or a silly spook may sit by your side, shrouded in a daft disguise.
They pretend to terrorize. Grim grinning ghosts come out to socialize.